Clotilde. Sister Anne, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I think it would be best if I stayed out of sight. And may I see the prioress? I have brought her a package of English tea.
How do you read me, over?
Hello, Ramrod. Hello, Ramrod. This is Rocket One. This is Rocket One. This is Snapper speaking. Reading you loud and clear. Over.
I've scouted Mont Saint Marie pretty well, but I see no activity up there. Over.
Look, I'm in a trap down here, and they're beating my brains out with artillery. Now, I don't know where the guns are, but the observation posts have got to be on that mountain. I wouldn't ask you if I didn't need your help. Can you bomb it? Over.
Yes, we can bomb it. No problem. I'll fly back to base now and make preparations, over.
I'll code coordinates, marker signals, and our timetable through my division to your headquarters right now. Is there anything else you need, over?
No, not a thing. Just some good bombing weather. Ramrod out.
They got observers all over that hill, pinpointing every move we make.
Colonel Farn, there are nuns, women and children up there, too. Now, does this Colonel Gallagher know that?
No, Father, he does not.
You can't let him make the attack without telling him.
I can't argue, Father. While I argue, my men die. I'll tell him after it's done. The important thing is that he bombs.
12 o'clock high. A QM production. Starring Paul Burke. Also starring Frank Overton and Chris Robinson. With guest stars Lilia Scala, Joseph Campanella, Richard Anderson. Special guest star Edward Mulhare. Tonight's episode, The Duel at Mont Saint Marie.
American guns are firing too?
Yes, searching for my batteries.
Oh, I pray that no one in the village will be hurt.
The village has been evacuated, Reverend Mother. But my chief concern is for you.
Us, we are safe.
Yes, I know. I gave my promise. But please stay indoors. If one of the American shells should fall short...
Word has been sent to the Americans.
Through the French. It is second hand.
Still, they know that our mound is sacred and this a holy place. We have faith that we are shielded here.
Of course.
I thank you, Colonel Schotten, for your gift of English tea.
You are welcome. May I visit with you again tomorrow?
You'll be welcome.
Right here. Mount St. Marie sits right here. Look. Top of this hill. It dominates this valley below. Their guns are dug into these hills behind the retreat. You can see it would take weeks to find them and dig them out.
If the fire from those guns is being directed from observation posts here below the retreat, it's got to be deadly.
Right. Come in.
General Dowd, sir.
Hello, Joe. How are you?
Howdy.
General?
When'd you get back?
About 20 minutes ago.
What'd you see?
Well, actually, it's a good target, an easy one. No problem at all. But it's not for B-17s. So let me set it up for an attack group, A-20s.
No chance, Joe. It's a problem of logistics, payload, range. You've flown tactical missions before with the heavies. This baby is yours.
Okay.
Well, let me tell you the rest. We heard from the French. In the retreat, there is a community of nuns and some refugees from the village.
Nuns? Have we sent anybody up there?
No, we haven't, but we tried.
Well, let's send someone. Get them out of there.
Joe, there's a local historical shrine. The prioress claims immunity. They refuse to leave.
Sounds like Monte Cassino all over again. You can bet those Germans are holding them there, using them.
Either way, we've got to bomb. Bomb before Goebbels tells the world about it.
Oh, and then what? Pretend we didn't know?
Now listen to me, Joe. I listen to me carefully. Mount Saint-Marie has held up the 22nd Corps for 3 days now. The flank has stopped and won't move until the 22nd does. Believe it or not, it's affecting the entire invasion. Now, the 108th Combat Team is ready to attack as soon as you bomb.
When?
Tomorrow, 0800.
No.
Joe, don't start in with me now.
Not tomorrow, Phil. Put it off.
I have been given an order which I can't refuse, and I have to pass it on to you.
How high up do they know about the nuns?
All they know is that we have to seize and keep this hill, and you know it too. By the way, Colonel Farnham sent up a flag of truce. It's still there, halfway up that hill. German artillery killed him.
No. Word from the French is just not enough for me. Let's try again. I'll try.
You'll try? What the devil are you talking about?
Phil, just give me 24 hours. Somehow I'll get up there. Harvey, he can set up the mission for a day after tomorrow. Well, let's try. Let's make an effort. At least allow me to make a personal, stupid, irrational effort. It's a lot better than being a bunch of executioners.
General Dowd, get me General Owens in London. Scramble the call. You got 24 hours, Joe.
I'll wait.
Harvey, get a B-17 ready as fast as you can. Order a fighter escort.
Will you go alone?
Sergeant?
Yes, sir.
Come in here a minute. Also have 9 bombers ready to strike day after tomorrow at 0700.
Sir?
Sandy, I want you to call communications. Have them send over a radio parachute pack. And also a parachute for me. Have it ready by tomorrow morning. I'm going to make a jump into southern France.
Yes, sir.
And Sandy, I'm going to have a liaison radio man go with me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, that's right, Harry. I want to delay the whole advance 24 hours. Right.
To Rocket One, I see your marker. Ready to make our drop in 30 seconds.
Roger, Carrier. This is Rocket One. The pickup party's in the gully, 50 yards south of the marker. Make your drop. We're ready. Rocket One out.
Stand by in the bomb bay.
Want to hold me up for 24 hours? What do? Just sit and watch my men get knocked off?
No. Just tell your men you don't want them sharing the blame for a bloodbath.
You think we don't want to avoid it? He sent up a 3-page letter.
He sent it? Why didn't he take it up himself?
Too many funerals down here, Colonel. Don't attack him. Kraut snipers would have blown his head off if he tried it.
And how did the letter get there?
Who says it got there?
Well, don't you know? Well, how can you say you tried if you don't know that?
All right. Jameson, get in here.
Colonel Gallagher, this is Sergeant Jameson. Tell him about the chaplain's letter.
Tell him what?
How'd you find the Frenchman?
Recon patrol.
What Frenchman? Is he a member of the underground?
Yes, sir.
Can the French get up on top?
So they say.
Then so can I.
You mean out of uniform?
No, not quite. Sergeant, I want you to get me a GI sweater, some kind of a cap, a pair of combat boots. Find me a Frenchman who knows a way to get up there.
Yeah, you, move. What are you, Mr. Do-Good?
How about a combat patrol to protect my liaison men?
Sure, sure. And some apple pie a la mode.
Colonel, maybe I should have gone before. I want you to take me with you.
Hey, you! Where do you think you're going?
Do not shoot! It is only me, Francois the farmer.
Come down slowly, Francois. And put your hands in here.
Always you speak to me as if you have never seen me before. Is there no one you fellows trust?
What you've got there?
Just another letter from the American chaplain. You want me to bring it up there, to the retreat?
Here, keep the trail open till you get back, sir.
Okay. Sandy, I want you to make sure you keep that radio hot and keep a walkie-talkie to your ear. But don't call me under any conditions. You might give your position away.
Yes, sir.
I'll call you if I need you.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
By what right do you invade my chapel?
Forgive us, Reverend Mother. It was unavoidable. I am a priest.
Then you, of all people,
should... Reverend Mother, are there any Germans here?
They're not.
Good. Then we can talk.
About what?
About getting these people out of here.
I sent a letter explaining the situation. The Germans had accepted it.
Are you Father Roman?
Yes.
I have your letter. and I have no intention ever of being driven from my retreat.
Reverend Mother, we do respect the sanctity of this place. That's the very reason we're here.
I vow never to leave. I have no
intent. Reverend Mother, as a priest, I can permit you to suspend your vow. And your order wouldn't expect you to keep your people here with a battle going on.
You will bring a battle here? Spill blood here?
Sir.
Reverend Mother,
tell the Colonel.
Well, I never thought of it before she refused to leave.
Thought of what?
Reverend Mother is a German.
I was born in Germany. And to satisfy any curiosity you may feel, I have two brothers in the Wehrmacht fighting on the Eastern Front.
Yeah, then knock, so let's get up.
Hold on.
I gave no vow to Germany. My sympathies are with humanity. We will not leave. That's my answer. Now go, the way you came.
Reverend Mother, there is nothing in our faith that gives the spiritual leader of even a small community dominion over life and death.
We have never been threatened with death until now. No German soldier has even carried a weapon into my compound.
Reverend Mother, then it's true? Do German soldiers come here that often?
This is a place of worship. I turn away no man of goodwill.
I see. And what about their commander? Is he a Christian?
Yes, he is.
And I wonder, would you send for him? Ask him to meet with me here. Tell him I want to talk to him.
Don't move!
Stop! Stop! Put your weapons aside! All of you! Put them down!
Jameson.
Please, take your weapons.
I'm Colonel Joseph Gallagher. United States Air Corps.
Your pistol.
Gerhard Schotten, Colonel Commanding Garrison Samari. Forgive us for bursting in with weapons, Reverend Mother. But Sister Anne came to us so frightened. You can imagine what we feared. How did you manage to come up here?
Colonel, let's talk about why I came up here. I was just asking the Reverend Mother to send for you.
Were you indeed?
You will all please wait in the courtyard. I shall return this when you leave. I'll show you to the fountain cellar. If you'll bring them that far, I shall put them away.
Climbing toward the top. You better warn your boss.
I can't, sir. You heard his order. Don't call.
We must persuade these people to get off this hill.
But, Colonel, the hill is theirs.
No, it was theirs. Until you started using it.
But you have seen we have no installation here.
No, of course not. Not here inside of the retreat. But you and your men do come here.
Occasionally. For worship.
What about the view? Look down there, Colonel. As you well know, those are our lines. Now, let's just reverse our situations for a minute. Suppose those lines were yours. Would you allow us to use this hill for whatever reason, if you could stop us?
You are Air Corps. I take it you mean to bomb the retreat.
The hill, Colonel, the hill. That's my target. But of course, I cannot bomb this hill without causing mortal danger to this retreat.
Simply because it's a military school, you were taught the axiom, take the high ground.
Yes, when the high ground is used as an observation post.
Does that justify the killing of innocent women and children? Holy women?
Colonel, I didn't come here to justify this. I am asking you to help me to prevent it. Now, the Reverend Mother is a countrywoman of yours, perhaps a friend. So if you have any concern whatsoever for the innocent, you will help me to persuade her to leave.
Very well, Colonel Gallagher. Let us discuss the facts, the military facts as they are. You suggest a course of action which is impossible. Reverend Butter, may I make a recommendation?
Has befriended us. Father Roman is a priest of our faith. They have recommended that I speak to you. Colonel Gallagher asks us to leave our sanctuary and seek safety elsewhere so that the Americans can bomb Mont Sainte Marie without causing injury and death here. Do I state it fairly?
Well, actually, the hill is our target, not the retreat. But we feel that we probably will hit the retreat. Now, understand, we realize that this place is very sacred to you. But unfortunately, the enemy has brought it into the war. He is using it. He has hidden observers on it to help him kill American soldiers.
No. No one has ever seen us dishonor your shrine. Nor can I believe that anyone will bomb it while you are still here. But if you wish to leave, I will do everything I can for you outside. There is no protection. And there is very little food. And there is also the question of your vow.
I release you from your vow if you wish to go. I must tell you, though, that my home, my church, and my life are here. And I shall stay.
Let me make something perfectly clear. If Colonel Schotten will come with me to the American lines and surrender Mount St. Marie, there'll be no bombing, and no American soldiers will come here.
Preposterous! Surrender? Is this finally your true purpose? You still insist on pretending that this is a military objective?
Well, if it isn't, why don't you just come with me and guarantee it?
What do you take me for? A fool? You cannot negotiate with me. You are, in fact, my prisoner.
Colonel, when we decided to come here, we were fully aware that we might be killed or captured. Now, do you want to hold me? Then go ahead, if that's the kind of victory you want.
Reverend Mother, we wish to leave. May God go with you. To stay, go to your quarters and bring essential things to the fountain cellar. It's the safest place. Go.
I've been to that fountain cellar. It's a cracker box.
Sister, may I see the cellar, please?
Colonel.
Just that?
These men did come with a flag of truce. Is it possible that their superiors might reconsider if you were to give them safe passage?
Yes, it is possible. Show them the cellar.
I think we're under the courtyard.
Mm-hmm.
I can understand now why the colonel let me see this. That roof wouldn't stop a hand grenade.
The abbots in olden times didn't dig deep here in solid rock. But there is no other place. So, if you must bomb...
Sister Martha, we will bomb. And I know exactly how and when. But if Colonel Shotton knew this, he would use it to save his men and destroy mine.
When will it come?
Soon enough. Too soon. But, sister, there's still time, so go. Please go.
When will it come?
I'm sorry. I can't tell you that. You might... He might somehow find out from you.
No, that's not what you believe. You believe that you can weaken me with fear. And you cannot. You use us in your vicious game.
Reverend Mother, you've never been tortured.
Chaplain.
Your Germany has changed.
Tortured?
For information. That's what Colonel Gallagher is risking.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Sister, please listen.
No, no. I want to talk to her alone. You wait outside, Colonel, please.
Herbert, Mother, you're behaving badly, and I have to tell you so. I accuse you of pride in your nationality, in your authority here, in your possessions.
Pride. Blinding you to the obvious, Reverend Mother, that Colonel Shotton, your countryman, is the one who's using your community, your lives, and your bodies. You have let him make you hostages against attack. You've listened to his voice and let it lull you, because you are afraid.
Father.
Come with me.
The cellar offers no protection. So if you bomb, you will simply be committing a mass atrocity.
And how can you...
Sisters, this way, please. Listen to me. I'm a priest, but I'm also an American soldier. I'll be taken prisoner when I do this. But I'm now prepared, with the permission of Reverend Mother, to lead you out of here. All of you who will go.
Did not occur within the sanctuary. Please remember that and understand. I wish you no harm. But you must, for the time, stay here. No one is permitted to leave this compound.
Briefing 0330. Warm up 505. Takeoff 525. I want all the latest information on weather, flak, and fighters.
Sorry, Sergeant.
Good evening, General.
All righty. Now, word from Joe. The mission goes. Time on target 0700.
I have the 9 best bombardiers we own. I want to blast that hill with the least possible damage to the retreat.
Who's leading?
Burton's pilot, Channing's bombardier. I'm commanding.
No deal, Harvey.
I'm not a bad pilot. I want to take this one out.
You bump the lead pilot. I'll lead the mission. You can fly right seat with me if you want to.
Sister, it's midnight.
I know. I try to pray. I don't know what to do.
Sister, go to Colonel Shotton. Talk to him. And you know the man. There must be some appeal you could make. Well, I know he lied to you, but don't you understand that's only part of the Germany that he represents?
Not my Germany.
Exactly. That's just the very point.
Colonel Shotton, my countryman, he deceives me and is false to his faith. You, my country's enemy, you come in love and mercy, and yet you will kill us.
Yes, sister, we know we kill. And we die fighting for what we believe. Don't you understand? We're in a war that was forced on us. And unfortunately, dead people can't build better worlds or stop wars. Sister Martha, regardless who drops the bombs or pulls the triggers, if you die here and they die with you, in a world that needs you, it'll be a pitiful waste.
Needs me. My pride has left me and I can see that I was blinded. But, Colonel, how can you ask us to go to that world outside which you have brought in here, and we can see that it is cruel and ugly and pitiless.
Sister Martha, whose world is it?
Mm-hmm. God's world.
I only have to give a simple signal and my men would attack.
Attack who? Us? No, Colonel. You know we'd fight back. And I don't think you'd want to risk killing some of these nuns. Your own men would revolt at that.
Neither one of us wishes to see these women die.
Exactly. So give a signal and let them go free.
If there is really to be an air raid, let me know exactly when it will come and I will get them out of here in time.
And have your men get off the hill and come back and reoccupy just as soon as the raid is over. No, Colonel. I didn't come here to bargain.
Only to destroy. Very well. If you bomb, Colonel, I will see to it that all your efforts are forgotten and only your atrocity remembered.
No, I can't raise Captain Rice. My guess is they wiped him out. Well, there's no word from the convent, but that doesn't change anything, Major. Yes, yes. Artillery at 0645 and bombers at 0700, and you jump off when the first bomb falls.
Major, better give me a time check.
It's 0630, sir. We'll be on the IP in 25 minutes.
Good.
Colonel, there's still enough time for you to get these women out of here. But there's not enough time for you to use this information, so now I can tell you, my bombers are going to be here in exactly 25 minutes. Wait a minute! No signals! No signals, and not you alone. If you go out of here, you go out of here with those women.
No matter what happens today, please remember you are in God's hands. Don't be afraid.
Give me that!
I couldn't make contact, so I came up here.
Got a couple of holes in here.
Yes, sir. The receiver's shot. I think the transmitter may work.
Ramrod to B-17 formation. Ramrod to B-17 formation. On a damaged radio, no receiver. If you hear me, hold your drop for 5 minutes. I repeat, if you can hear me, hold your drop for 5 minutes.
This is Castle Leader to formation. Gentlemen, let's do this right. I don't want to have to send another mission here. Castle Leader out.
Colonel, I think I've understood you all along, but now I'm going to give the order. Lead these people out of here.
My orders were to hold Mont Saint-Marie at all costs. This includes my life.
All right. I'll lead you out. Follow me.
Come, come on. Don't be afraid.
Are you going to allow that?
If you open that gate, my men will open fire.
Wait. Forgive me. I came to think of this retreat as mine. It is God's. And you are not my charges. You are the children of God. He will lead us.
Sister.
He will lead us.
Mommy?
Turn around and hold your drop for 5 minutes.
So look, they're turning. They're turning!
Hey, use this. Bring the colonel. He'll get us through.
No! When the German soldiers see our bombers come back, they'll run for their holes. We'll get through. Come on.
Bombs away in 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bombs away.
Here.
Hello, sister.
Hello.
They told me in the village that you'd come back.
Many years ago, there was also a battle here. The abbey was besieged. There was no water. But a spring appeared right here. And it saved them. It was a miracle. Now, see our little shrine? It came safely through all the bombing and the battle. Do you think it's another miracle?
You know, sister, we didn't do quite as much damage here as I thought we might. But it's bad enough, and I'm sorry.
Resurrection has more than one meaning. This, we will build again.
Yes, and we'll help you. I promise. Well, goodbye, sister.
Goodbye.